we didn't know that months later we would be in COVID-19. But one thing that stood tall and firm from the very beginning was the opening of MSY, opening up to international and domestic travel, and we never looked back. And standing here today, and even when we opened it, I said on that day that MSY would be the real example of the city of New Orleans investing big in partnership with the federal government, in partnership even with the state of Louisiana, of how New Orleans maintains her assets, how New Orleans will continue to lean in terms of innovation and technology, and how we would ensure that we cement our foundation in being a world-class city and having a world-class airport. And I want to say thank you to the leadership that is assembled right here on this dais and the hard-working men and women who drive this airport every single day, meaning tending to the needs of all of our travelers, both from New Orleans and those visiting our beautiful, beautiful city and the state of Louisiana. So today, of course, we're here to talk about the digital solutions like LA Wallet, Louisiana Wallet. And so I'm looking forward to joining our governor as we go through the TSA line with the latest technology that only exists in 8 airports around the country and the 1 airport right now in the state of Louisiana. So there's a real commitment here, Governor, that we continue to move on and move forward. Your continuity and leadership and that you bring, I'm proud of it, and I thank you for this day and what's to come. So it is an honor. Let's welcome Governor Landry to the podium. Thank you.
Thank you. You know, we all know that Louisiana has its challenges, but we are absolutely committed to making this state great and the city of New Orleans. And I'm proud to stand here by the mayor and the distinguished guests set up here, and extremely excited about the work that Dan Casey has done as our new OMB director, and his staff have worked tirelessly with TSA to make New Orleans one of, as she said, one of the 8 states in the country to be able to host a digital solution wallet. We all know that anytime that you can increase security and IDing in airports, you basically increase expediency. And I can tell you from all these passengers here, and from being one, you know, the First Lady and I travel, anytime you can move through an airport seamlessly and quickly, that's important. But what you really hate to do is get up to the TSA gate and forget your wallet. And then you don't know what to do, and your house might be an hour or so away, or maybe longer, and they won't let you in. Rightfully so. But today that all changes in New Orleans, because if you have an LA wallet and if you get a real ID and if you go through the process, you will be able to use your mobile phone as a wallet to be able to move quickly through TSA. And then our hope, and after speaking to the TSA director here in Louisiana, is that by the end of the year, we are hoping that all airports in Louisiana will be able to use LA Wallet as those passengers in Louisiana go through those airports. And hopefully the rest of the country will follow suit with Louisiana as well. So it's a great day. I look forward to going through TSA today with the First Lady and Dan Casey and the mayor, and to show all of Louisiana how this is one place where Louisiana is actually leading. Thank you. And
thank you, Governor Landry, First Lady, Mayor. Today's a great day for the state of Louisiana. When federal, state, and local governments work together with the private sector, we can improve the quality of our life for our residents. We know traveling can be stressful. We also know that whether it's vacation or business, it's hard sometimes to get through TSA. This is another great tool for us to use, like the governor said, when we forget our wallet. Since 2018, Louisiana has led the way in this arena. We have been we're the very first state to adopt a mobile driver's license. We have the highest adoption rate in the country. That is a testament to the states and our embracing technology. It's important for us to continue to move forward. We're excited for our partners here at TSA to accept LA Wallet here at New Orleans International and 26 other airports. Our work's not done. Mobile driver's licenses are just one example of how the Office of Motor Vehicles is actively working to modernize our services and to make everyday life easier for Louisiana residents. I want to thank you, Governor, for your support in helping us move forward in upgrading our systems and our efficiencies in our offices. One thing that will make everyone's life easier is getting a real ID. If you plan to continue to use your driver's license or want to use LA Wallet, you must get a real ID in to do that. The deadline for real ID is May 7th, 2025. So please go to expresslane.org, click on Real ID, and it will give you a checklist on how to get your real ID at one of our field offices. Again, I thank you everyone for coming today. I thank the governor, the mayor, the first lady. And at this time, I'd like to hand the pulpit over to Judge Michael Bagnaris, the chairman of the New Orleans Aviation Board.
Good morning, everyone. First of all, I'd like to thank the governor and the mayor for being here. And while I'm issuing thanks, I'd also like to thank you, Dan, with the Office of Motor Vehicle, and Mr. Hudson with the TSA. I appreciate the fact that everybody is here to bring about more awareness of this innovation that we're about to introduce here at the airport. You know, anybody that knows me knows that I am a digital dinosaur. The digital revolution came and went, and I missed it. If the only thing I can do is text, email, and talk on the phone, and I'm even limited there, because if you get a happy birthday from me, all you're going to get is a happy birthday. There's no Thank you, Dan. No emojis that's coming from this individual. If you see any balloons falling or some singer saying happy birthday, hang up, I've been hacked, all right? The only emoji I know about is I could do that one, all right? So I was a little bit leery when we heard that, when I realized a few months ago that we were about to bring about the digital ID. And then I learned how easy it was. And for me, that's a big deal. You know, it is, not only is it easy, the big selling point of it is, as the governor had indicated, that speed, that security, that safety that you get with the Louisiana Wallet being used as the digital ID. Now, it's that type of innovation that has caused this airport to win 3 years in a row, the best airport in North America. But we're not going to settle for just the best airport in North America. We're looking for worldwide domination here, all right? We're going to be the best in the world because we're going to keep innovating, and it's that type of action that brings about the ability for us to compete in this global community, and that's where we are. We are at the forefront of the 21st century in terms of bringing about change. And that change is going to benefit the whole of Louisiana, in terms of bringing about, enabling us to compete and bringing about jobs and businesses to this state. So we're very, very happy about that. And in introducing the next party, I'd simply like to add a few more thanks. I began with a thanks, I'd like to end with a thanks. And that thing goes to all of the employees of this airport, the executive staff led by Mr. Dolio, and of course, the airline partners and my fellow board members. It is that type of unity and working together that brings about these types of innovations. So thank you to everyone, and of course the users of the airport as well. And with that, I'd like Mr. Hudson to step forward. Thank you.
Good morning. Well, my job is easy because they've taken all of my talking points. So let me also welcome Governor Landry, Mayor Cantrell, Commissioner Casey, Chairman Bagnaris, and Director Dolio. As TSA continues to integrate technologies for an efficient, easier, and always secure traveling experience, we are proud to introduce the collaboration with the state of Louisiana on this digital initiative. Louisiana becomes the eighth state in the country, as they all mentioned earlier, to move forward with the mobile driver's license. So I ask everyone to pause for a moment and applaud the state for moving forward with this cutting-edge technology. As also mentioned, Louisiana MSY is the first airport in the state to use the latest TSA technology known as CAT-2. That's mobile equipment that's equipped with driver's license readers. The CAT system allows a traveler to utilize their LA Wallet app, approach a ticket document checker at the checkpoint, tap their mobile phones, and the mobile driver's license reader will pick up that reader on the camera. Then it'll allow one of our officers to capture that real ID photo, compare it with the issued state ID, and then it will show in real time whether that passenger is ticketed for that day, and they don't need to show their boarding pass or utilize their physical ID, which is a great thing. But in doing so, what they do is that information is transferred to a secure network called Secure Flight with the program with TSA, and it'll allow us to immediately match that driver's license with that photo, and then it'll expedite that passenger's experience. So with all that being said, I want to thank the governor, the mayor, the commissioner, and everybody else on the panel for this great day with TSA and LA Wallet. Thank you for all the hard work. It's been 9 years in the making. We're here. I want to thank all of the back staff, all of the people behind the scenes that have made this concept come to fruition. Thank you again. I turn it back over to Aaron.
All right, and without further ado, our Director Dolio.
Well, I get cleanup duty today. I get to be the guy that reminds or directs everyone to the proper location for the rest of the ceremony. So what we're going to do at this point is escort everyone up. The escalator's here. Are the escalators there?
We're back.
We are. Let me say this. This innovation, I'm very proud that our state is really on the leading edge of bringing this type of technology into people's identification and other needs. It really allows us as an airport, we're out ahead of many airports in the country, and allowing this type easy, safe, secure passage through our TSA checkpoint. Chairman Bagnaris touched on or mentioned the 3 years in a row of winning great recognition for this airport. This, amongst other things we've done here over time and will be doing going forward, will continue to place us in a position of being one of the best, if not the best, in our category airport going forward. We're not resting on our laurels. We didn't stop after completion of this facility. There's more to come in that regard. But in the meantime, we keep adding different amenities and we keep a forward-looking approach to providing for the traveling public through this facility. So I'm just very happy that this is the latest amenity, really, and safety measure that's come into the airport. And I thank the governor for his leadership, the mayor for her leadership in providing for us locally and what we've done with the airport over time. So with that, I'll tell you a short story and I'll tell you why I'm gonna cut it right now. As I've been the airport director in three airports over time, consulted to a number of airports around the country, and one of my moves from one airport to the next, the PIO, or my director of communications in a new airport, tells me a week into my tenure, is it true that you're a very dangerous man if you're not scripted, that I have to script you whenever you go out? And I say, yeah, it's true. I was reminded by my past PIO after a great luncheon speech that, Mr. Dolio, you have to remember, this is a luncheon. These people have to go back to work. So with that, I'm going to cut it and give direction to get us up to the next level, to lane 11. This way. Okay.